Before you ride off into the night, my friends, here's a story for the road. It's my own story of the West. The Saga of the Ponderosa.
Behind me lay the stormy sea that I would sail no more. The love that was so dear to me lay buried on the shore. And my arms were holding my newborn son, reminding me that the past was done. And the wind I heard carried a strange sounding word. The dusty road ahead of me was calling like a friend. My hungry boots were itching me to reach the other end, where the land was free and the years turned slow, with room for me and my son to grow. And the west wind came, bearing that strange sounding name. Adam was a yearling when we reached the old Missouri, and I labored day and night to buy a wagon and a team, cause my hopes were in a hurry. But suddenly my heart stopped me flat in my tracks, like that. 'Twas a woman gay and pretty, sparkling with joy, and I wanted her to share my dream. Our wedding cake was light as down, with a Valentine bride in a frosting gown, and she was all things beautiful and a mother to my boy. We started off together on that February morn, through Nebraska, down to Kansas, through the spring and autumn weather, to the edge of Colorado, where my second son was born. Husky and jolly and hardly ever cross, my wife named him Eric, but I called him Hoss. My life was full of happiness, too wonderful to tell, when down upon our wagon train there swarmed a savage hell, made of Cheyenne arrows and dying men. And all my sorrows returned again, and the wind wept in the sky, telling my dead love goodbye. I took my sons and mothered them, but fear had left its shadow that seemed to grow the farther on we went in Colorado. For the land rose up till it stood on end with a crown on top, cold and white. And the days were made of riding and of slipping and of sliding, and my boys couldn't hide their fright. I would wake up in the night and hear them crying in the sleep, and I'd weep. But they never knew, and somehow we got through. From Utah to Nevada, it was easy all the way. We left behind that shadow and it faded day by day. For the sweet wind caroled a laughing tune. The wagon wheels rumbled, we'll get there soon. And the ground all around thundered that strange rolling sound. Virginia City. Boomtown, brash bold town, wild silver and gold town, where I worked and I gambled and I watched my fortune grow, till disaster dealt a hand I couldn't play. Big Joe Collins was a friend, and my life would have ended, but he saved it at the cost of his own. And his wife was alone, far away from the West, and I couldn't refuse his last request. I made the sad and weary trip and told her how he died. And from the day I saw her tears, I couldn't leave her side. And the months flew by like so many startled birds. We both seemed to know, without uttering the words, that my friend would have wanted it so. And I brought her west, and she became more lovely as a mother, for she gave my boys a brother, and we called him Little Joe. Well, it was time to find my land and to build a dream I'd planned. So I started off alone, and the wind led me on to a valley rich as Eden, where the trees were like the pillars of a temple, with a wide blue dome. And all at once, I knew this place was home. I asked an old trapper what kind of trees they were, but he went right on dragging in his lines. Then he raised his ancient head, and I shivered, for he said, We call them Ponderosa Pines. And on 500,000 acres of that strange-sounding name, I staked my claim. My sons have grown to manhood as the years have drifted on, and each of them reminds me of a love that's past and gone. But the strength that flows from the earth and the pine warms my heart like a vintage wine, with a love rich and strong. For this is where we belong, on the Ponderosa.